We are in Tbilisi, the capital city of the country of Georgia, waiting for the train. A typical Soviet subway, both the trains and the stations are basically identical throughout all the vast expanse of the former communist empire. Sophie is happy, playing. We've got off at Liberty Square, walking past the Parliament of Georgia. This is called the Kasveti Church of St. George, one of countless cute little old churches you can see in this city, which is situated inside the Central Park of 9th April. Walking through one of the city's omnipresent street markets, one can find all sorts of things in them, mostly second-hand items from antiques and artworks to kitchenware and books. And it's probably the only place in the world one can see displayed souvenirs of Joseph Stalin. Checking out a nice view of that river with a name I rather not try to pronounce. And continuing our walk through the city's nice shaded parks. This one's called Leonidze Park. Another typical of the Soviet Union underground passage. And this is Liberty Square itself with its gilded monument of St. George. We continue our walk through the old town of Tbilisi, many cute old houses and churches around here and many stairs to climb. Many steps later, we made it to the ridge of the hill. There is also a cable car we could have taken there, but okay, we do have legs.
Good job.
A lovely place for a walk, great views of the city and some interesting ruins. There's also a botanical garden up there, but I wasn't much willing to pay the entrance fee. We rather walked along the ridge and went past the Mother of Kartli, one of the city's most notable landmarks, and made it to Narikala Fortress, the city's most crowded touristy hotspot. A nice place, we didn't need to pay a ticket to enter, at least not through the broken wall we climbed. Many souvenir shops and touts and stuff. And some amazing views of the entire elongated city and the river. They also had a zip line, a bit too expensive for my reason. And this is the cable car taking the easy way up the hill. Back down to the city and its oldest part, walking past its famed sulfur baths. Another tourist hotspot, some kids there try to sell us a cup of juice for some 8 euro. Another old church and a statue of an ancient king overlooking the river. Many hustlers try to sell us a cruise around there. Porsche advertising duly with this huge air balloon. This is stationed in Rike Park, the largest one in central Tbilisi. I preferred the other parks on the other side of the river. Here there was no shade and it was scorching hot in the middle of the day. We are crossing the Peace Bridge back to the West Bank, a very cute and artistic pedestrian overpass. Rammed with selfie-taking tourists. We kept walking through the picturesque streets of Old Tbilisi. A very nice city overall, an interesting combination of the traditional with the modern, although not a big fan of urban traveling myself, I very much enjoyed my time there and I would gladly go back at the first opportunity. more street markets, although I never buy things I don't have a very good use for. I found it pretty recreational to be checking out all the curiosities they had for sale. Plenty of paintings too. Like in many other cities, for some reason I could never understand, the artists weren't very fond of us recording and taking pictures of their work. On another day of our stay in the Georgian capital, we took a trip to Tbilisi Lake that is found north-west from the city. This is us climbing towards it through the graveyard.
What do you think it is?